Hi, welcome you all to a new episode of Sportsy. Let's talk sports. Today we'll be talking about an interesting aspect of sports technology. We have with us CEO founder of Stupa Analytics, Megha. She's been a computer science person, worked in a company like Cognizant, EY, and then from there followed her passion towards entrepreneurship and combining that with sports. And the fun part is she's working in the industry, which in the analytics, she's working on something on the racket sport. Recently signed a great deal with US Table Tennis. She's been working with World Table Tennis, Ultimate Table Tennis, and trying to go beyond table tennis to other racket sports. Looking forward to this amazing chat with Megha Gambhir, CEO of Stupa. Please do like, share, and subscribe. Please do subscribe to our channel and help us spread the word about Sportsy, where we want to talk about sports more and more. Thank you. Hi, Megha. Great to have you on Sportsy. Let's talk sports. Honestly speaking, it's going to be fun talking to you on sports because looking at your career, you've been with a company like Cognizant and EY and then coming into sports and founding a company, that too in the sports analytics, like Stupa Analytics, with a great news of current signing with US Federation, Table Tennis Federation. Congratulations on that. And yes, so tell us how an IT professional turned up into sports and that to sports technology.
Okay, so first of all, thank you for having me here, and I'm really excited about your chat show because I mean, honestly, to me, because I've recently shifted to sports industry, I think it's going to be a great kind of a knowledge and informative tool for everyone who are in sports industry, and also for the people the kind of students who are planning to come into the sport industry. So it will be a good meet for them too, in terms of knowledge. I hope this goes well.
Yes.
So to talk about myself, so the shift from IT to sport was not an easy shift. Although, I had my own journey, traveling through it while coming from IT to sport. And I had a backup in the sport as well, because my husband, who's another co-founder, happens to be a table tennis player. And he's now the coach as well. He was a former Indian team, national team coach as well. So I had that kind of backing up of sport, but still the journey wasn't very easy. So I was doing very good in my career in IT, and I have approximately 13 years of industry experience while I was working with Cognizant and EY. And there I was working with very good clients like World Bank, United Nations, and then I've got a chance to work with American Express, PepsiCo India.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, but then I think there was something inside me to, I don't know why, to become an entrepreneur, and I wanted to actually do something of my own. And this thought was sparking inside me from quite long, actually, while I was in EY in 2017 and 18. So this this actually thought went on in the top, and literally I just took a decision that okay, I'll just try my hands on something, but I didn't know that what to pick up, and that's why I just left my job and I just started exploring a little. I just started traveling. I did some trekking. I did some traveling. Meanwhile, I was thinking what to start with. Mm-hmm. And that was kind of a refreshing sort of break for me as well, because I've never had such a long break in my career, because we used to slog for so many number of hours in a corporate industry, right? So, yeah, so that's how, it all started. Eventually, me and Deepak were talking about sports analytics as well, because Deepak, being a national team coach as well, and he's into from past 20 years, he wanted to actually have some sort of analytics coming out to help him actually, training his athletes. Mm-hmm. And that was the time where actually I thought that why not to merge technology? So I thought that, okay, fine, I'll bring out my experience of technology and he being into sport. So we can merge both of these two things, and why not to come out with something? So that's how the journey started.
Oh, nice. So basically you took your the married life compatibility to your professional life compatibility.
Yeah, you can say that. Yes.
Excellent. So I always say that, okay, the way you said that I quit my job and get bit there, I read a book about antarprerna, which is related to entrepreneurship. Something comes from within, and that's the time everything, that suddenly light comes and you say, okay, I'll go for it. But did you get a chance to pick anything but table tennis?
So I think, we usually, since we have met, we have met in college. Since we have met, we are talking about table tennis as well. So I never happened to play any sport, because my family was not oriented to sports that much. But then ever since I met him, I actually really like sports. So I started playing table tennis. I play a little badminton as well. But then, when we are talking, it's all table tennis. It's all associated with table tennis. In fact, my wedding card was of the shape of racket. You can ever imagine that. So to that level, he's passionate about table tennis, and so is me now about sports now.
Yeah. So hope you exchange the garlands and not the rackets. Okay. Coming back to your technology background and aligning that with sports. So what exactly is sports analytics? How do you look at sports analytics as an industry?
See, when I entered into sports analytics, I started reading a lot about it. And I did a lot of study about the competitors we have in the market right now in sports analytics. So according to what I have gone through and I have studied, I personally feel that there is a huge sort of potential, and a potential market is available right now, because sport analytics on whole, there are only few sports which is being covered by sports analytics. Rest of the sports are still looking for some sort of help from analytics side. And I could see from table tennis itself, because when I saw in table tennis from my husband that yes, there is a need of it. Similarly, when I started speaking about speaking to other coaches as well, like for example lawn tennis or other coaches, so I saw that there is a huge potential into analytics market. And the another aspect which I look forward to is that analytics at this moment is quite costly, and it is being used by only professional players and professional coaches who are willing to make their career in sports. However, actually, my perspective is that analytics should be actually coming out to each and every level. I mean, it can be used by amateurs as well. Similarly, the weight is being used by pro players. Yes, the intensity will vary. The pro player intensity will be higher because they will be working towards their performance and all. However, I mean, data can do a lot of fun for amateurs as well. So that's my actually thought of looking into sports analytics market, and that's where, I mean, we are heading towards to it.
Okay. So now what is Tupa Analytics? It's analysis which is giving it, it looks good. I read about it during the UTT days. I spoke to Hiren also about it. Professionals are used to, like, I was talking to Sharat earlier. He said, yes, sports analytics is playing a big role. Technology is helping us differently. But how is this helping the amateur level, and how do you try to plan to bring the cost down for amateurs to actually get useful for themselves?
So basically, I'm talking about bringing it to a level where anyone can use it and how we can, I mean, be economical, we are bringing artificial intelligence into it. So we are, removing the human intervention into it and the manual labor which is there in analyzing a match, and that's how we are planning that. The artificial intelligence will bring it down the price. To a very low level, and then anyone can use it through their mobiles only, because the kind of technology we are bringing in is going to bring a drift in sports analytics as well, because so far the analytics is being done with high speed cameras and all, but what we are trying to bring in is to bring the intelligence to the mobile phone camera. And that's how anyone who's a player or an amateur or a professional player or an advanced level player can use it. Okay. So that's how we are bringing the cost down. And when I'm talking about the fan engagement part as well, so the similar approach we are going to take there as well, because right now we have a team who's doing a lot of analytics for real-time matches.
Right.
And but we are bringing artificial intelligence to that as well, wherein we can do a lot of analytics real time without any human intervention. And then again, I mean, it will be a sort of auto mode, wherein many of the leagues which are happening, just not in India but outside as well, can use it. In fact, just not the leagues, I would say that many of the national tournaments or any other kind of tournaments, international tournaments, can use this kind of a product to bring out a lot of insights about the match itself, which can be a very useful insight for the fans, because it's very important to actually engage the fans just by showing the score or just by showing some minute details about the match will not actually help fans understanding the game as well. And that is our perspective. So we are working on the athlete performance as well, and we are working on as well as the fan engagement part as well.
Okay, so I think this is pretty exciting, Omega. My question is, the professionals can have a support staff to help them tracking the number or where the ball is actually dropping and how every shot is getting hit. At the amateur level, who is collecting data, or is it something that gets recorded at a particular angle and then it can be interpreted?
Yeah, so that's basically the secret mantra we have. So it's going to be done automatically by just a mobile camera itself. And our model is so strong and so robust that it can do all the tracking and capturing of ball speed, ball bounce, coming out with analytics on its own. So we will be running most of the analytics on the mobile phone itself. Yes, a lot of inferencing will happen on the cloud as well, on the server as well, where athlete has to upload some of the videos to get advanced analytics. But purely it is going to be the AI model which we are building and we are coming out with. So it will be that only.
Okay, so right now it may be a B2B, but I think soon you will go to B2C level to have the mass expansion of the product usage as well, right? I think that is where the secret sauce also lies for the growth. Okay.
Yes. That's the plan actually, to actually cover B2C market. And we are going to be going like a subscription-based model. So people can just subscribe to the app, and then they can just use the number of hours of recording and then record it. They can use in their practice sessions. They can use in their matches as well, or they can use in their I'm in fitness as well, because we are bringing in with other fit tech component as well, which will do a lot of help in their fitness assessment as well.
Okay. So what has been your best testimonial? Who by given by a federation or a player, what has been your best testimonial?
So far, we have worked with many athletes, actually. I mean, many top brand athletes, I would say. I mean, like Manav Thakkar, who's currently India number one.
Correct.
He has been using our services from past like almost 8-9 months.
Okay.
And Kanak Jha, who's world number 26 right now in men's, he's using the services. And we are bringing out his testimonial out in this month itself. But I think from my own experience, I would like to talk about Manav Thakkar, because I was closely working with him as well, because he's the India's topmost talent at the moment, after Sachin, to whom people are actually looking up to. So basically, we have seen there is a huge shift in his game when he started the services, and after he used the services on the regular time. He got his all the matches analyzed, and then practices also analyzed, and then we share the feedback with the coach, and then they seem to be working on their particular aspect. And one of the very good example is that Manav himself said that he never used to, he has never got a chance to win any single game against Sachin in his entire career. And during his last nationals, which happened to be in Kerala, in the month of, November or December. Mm-hmm. So he actually, it was in January. So he actually won against him in the semifinals of national championship. So a person who has never won against Sachin, a single set. So based on the analysis, because we had his matches with Sachin from the UTT and some past tournaments as well. So we analyzed it, and I gave it to his coach as well. And then during the match, during the day when he has a match, the morning he actually started practicing according to the analysis. And then just in the afternoon, we saw that he could beat him very easily. He beat him. He's beaten him 4-2. So it was a witness. Eyewitness case where I could see that how actually the shift has happened.
Oh, nice! I think that also gives you more confidence about what you're doing is right.
Yes.
Yeah. And so you recently signed a deal with US Table Tennis Association. You already working with Bundesliga, UTT, and I think the Asian Federation as well, if I'm not wrong, Asian Table Tennis. So I just want to know, how is your experience working with the more advanced geographies vis-a-vis somebody like India, where it is still considered to be it's in top 10, but it is still an upcoming sport. We've been still talking about Kamlesh Mehta, still talking about Sharad Kamal, and Manika got the glamour to it. But UTT actually gave a face to table tennis in India. But outside, the table tennis is being played at different level. Like Bundesliga is phenomenal, the way US does. So how do you see the difference between the conduct and how the adaptability of technology has been there versus India?
So, in terms of federations, Bundesliga, we will be working with them from September onwards. UTT, we have done already, but this year we have reached out by Bundesliga as well. So they really want to use the broadcasting and fan engagement content for their Bundesliga. So that's something we are looking up to. In terms of the kind of change or the kind of viewpoint, I personally feel that Indian sports need a lot of awareness at the moment. I won't say that they are not tech savvy. They are tech savvy, but then still, I personally feel that many of the coaches in India still need that kind of awareness that how analytics can help them.
Right.
Because with me coming out with sports analytics in table tennis, I could see International Table Tennis Federation recognizing it. I could see Japan Table Tennis Association recognizing it. USATT signed up with us. But still, we need, I think a lot of work to be done on the awareness part in India, mm-hmm. because many of the coaches and the athletes still feel that it is not that important part. A coach can, the analysis, or a coach can see and then analyze the things and can work on the performance. However, there is another aspect to it wherein you bring in a lot of scientific elements, like you are working on the mental conditioning, you are working on the physical conditioning. So as that, you have to work on the feedback as well. And the feedback cannot be bring out by a coach or an athlete alone. So you do require a certain assistance by a performance analyst mind itself, mm-hmm. who can give you that kind of a specific assistance. Right. And so that you can optimize your training, you can work on the training plans accordingly, and then you can bring the performance to the next level. So I still believe that a lot of awareness needs to be done in India.
Yeah, and I think that is what even the Hiren mentioned, that the way they are looking at a grassroots development and a lot of academies coming to it, I think it makes a lot of sense, because it's an exciting sport, and it is something that you can play it at home on your dining table. At the same time, you can play it professionally on the big table and just enjoy it. It's a one-to-one sport. And I've seen people like Sachin or MS also getting excited about table tennis. In their free time, they play table tennis. So table tennis always, in India, was always there as a recreational sport, but now suddenly has taken the front seat to become a professional sport. And I think with UTT and what you guys are doing, 11 sports coming together, I think it's a great journey in the whole process. I have one question about the technology side again. We have seen the smart cricket bat with some wearable behind the cricket bat. So I have used an adapter which goes at the bottom of the table, badminton racket. Understand? Is there something that is there for table tennis or can be used for table tennis which will actually enhance your analytical ability?
Actually, you have come to the right point, because we are also planning to bring IoT, some sort of these things as well into table tennis. So far, our core focus into artificial intelligence, wherein we want to give the services with no more additional asset or with no more additional sort of item to be bought by a user. But eventually we want that to make it more accurate and to make it more and more precise in terms of the ball spinning and the kind of revolutions it is taking, and many other aspects. We are also thinking of bringing out some sort of IoTs as well, like some sort of sensors which can be plugged into the tip of the racket. And then it can provide useful information. I know that company who's doing it in cricket. I even reached out to them for table tennis as well. So, yeah, that's the plan for future. Eventually, we will be bringing out many other things as well.
Mm-hmm.
Pro players and coaches.
Nice. Because one cricket company called Straight Bat out of Bangalore is what... I was associated with, helped them with some of the market expansions. And I found it very fascinating, because, yes, cricket bat is very heavy. So that small strip doesn't make a big of a difference in the weight. But for table tennis, because I could feel the weight of that adapter on the badminton racket. So I can imagine how much finesse that you need to have in your wearable if you're going to put it on a table tennis racket, because the weight matters and the swing matters, a lot of things matter at such a small compact place.
Yes, and in fact, table tennis being the racket itself is very light as compared to cricket bat, and I also feel that in table tennis, I think the federations as well or the people who are playing as well has to be more open towards using such gadgets. But I personally feel that even if I'm not sure, whether it can be used live during the matches itself, because that has to come through the parent body, whether you can use such gadgets or not. But I think at least in practice sessions, it can be very useful.
So I think it's correct. And it is non-intrusive for the players. I think it may help them a lot. Going forward, and aligning with your AI base, the camera that you're talking about, and this kind of thing, it actually makes the whole setup ready for the player to be ready for those kind of challenges. I think it's amazing. So now, moving from the sports tech and sports analytics, I want to touch upon an aspect which is entrepreneurship. And because the industry that we are in, there are companies coming up, but at the same time, everybody's not sure what the next customer is in sports industry. So when you took your leap of faith and it has worked out, touch wood it is, and it will go far ahead from where we are right now. What has been the toughest thing that you had, other than quitting your job and starting something? What was the toughest thing that you had in your journey of last two and a half years?
I think the toughest thing which I have faced is basically, it is very important to have a very good team with you. And it is very important to actually ingrain that passion which you have inside you in the others as well. And right. When you're working in an industry like sports tech, which is itself is a unique and a niche market, then your options of getting, that sort of people is even lesser.
Yes.
And when you're again working in table tennis, where again it's a smaller segment within sport yes. itself, so you're shrinking your people who are going to be an asset to your company. So I think the biggest challenge I was facing is that me alone or with my husband we were working, but the challenge was to have a nice good team. Who has who has actually the table tennis background as well, who are table tennis athletes as well, because it is very important to have the game knowledge, as well as are willing to actually work and believe in this kind of a passion. Because in an industry where analytics was not there at all, like TT, yes. fraternity, there was no analytics, and then to bringing out something very newly, it took us time actually to make people understand whom yeah. we feel that can be part of our team, and then having them as a valuable asset. So I think building a team was the biggest challenge, but I touch wood, I have a nice team.
Yes.
Although they are very young, they all are very young and smaller than me, in the age, but then they have a passion and they are willing to actually, I would say that change the world. So
nice.
Yeah. So the team was the biggest challenge.
Yeah, and I as you rightly said that yes, I have been part of few startups here and there, and always the team makes a lot of difference, because you are as good as your team. It could be sport or it could be startup. You are as good as your team. So I think kudos to you with that kind of that journey and solving that part side of the puzzle in the whole journey. What has been, so one question is, what has been your yay moment yet? It's like, yeah, I have it's like that yay moment. Yay. It's like, I finally, for me, when it comes to sports, I'm a fan. I'm a fanatic. So yay is the biggest reaction I give.
See, so far, I would say there has been many yay moments for me, because we were not expecting too much to be done in this 1 year. However, we have gotten much more than we expected. We have got ITDF, we have got USATT and all that, and now we are planning to work with Bundesliga. But I think the yay moment was when we completed UTT, because UTT was the first ever project. I would say that, in fact, my company itself was not properly formed when I got this project.
Oh.
I really thank the UTT team for trusting us, because at that point in time we were really forming a team as well, and it's just that we were having that passion to do something different, mm-hmm. and we were able to do it also. But when we were doing UTT during that time itself, before UTT itself, there were many technical issues, glitches, right. problems we were facing, but we could somehow just work on it and then cross them step by step. And when there was a final day of UTT, when it was finished, that was a yay moment, because that was a successful sort of project delivery we have done.
Right.
Despite of all the challenges, I have actually even gotten typhoid in between because of so much stress I was having at that point in time, because I wanted to deliver the best. And right. because we were very new in this, so there was a lot of pressure on me as well. So I've gotten sick also, and then we have had lot many issues, but still I think on air, when stats were coming out, it was phenomenal. Cool. There was no issues. Was there, and UTT team was equally very happy with our performance. So that was a yay moment, because we could actually finish something very positively.
Excellent. And I'm sure Kamlesh sir and Hiren and Vita herself is like, they're amazing team to work with, and very they're always encouraging in yes. because the way they think itself is very encouraging about what they want to. They're so passionate about the whole table tennis as a game. So it's a really great
definitely award. See, they are the first ones who gave us that opportunity to work on it, right? I mean, that was like a opening a door for us.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like I mentioned, that even when we were smaller as well and we were just budding, at that point in time, they showed trust on us, and they opened the door. Very, very good exposure and experience for us as well.
Excellent. So now, there is one last segment that I want to talk about is, okay, we spoke about sports, we spoke about entrepreneurship. And in sports, I always focus on women in sport. And now I'm talking about women entrepreneurs in sport. So what is that journey been? Is it been different, or it just happened to you and it really happy for what it is? Just to share for that experience.
So that experience is actually very different. I have never thought that I will be becoming an entrepreneur in sport, tech, especially because I belong from a tech background, and sports happens to be with me because of my connection with sport at home. But then I never thought that I eventually will land up into it, because when I was leaving my job, I was not having any sort of this thing in my mind that I will start something in sports tech. In terms of the journey I've had, I think luckily I have met people who are very encouraging, and I have a very good family support as well. My sister and my husband and my mother, father, so they all have been very supportive, and I've never felt that actually like I'm a woman entrepreneur. I felt like I'm a normal human being, like a man or a woman. Yeah. In this journey, I've never felt like that because of the support I've been getting from my family members as well as the people I have met, and I think now the scenario is changing. Yes. And I have met many people who encourage women entrepreneurs. Yes. And also help them actually, and also trust them. So yes, that kind of confidence I've seen in many big people out there, and I really, really like this kind of a shift which is happening, because it is very important for the society as well to accept women entrepreneurs or women actually coming out into any other sort of area. So us, because we believe that we can definitely move the mountains, but other people in the society as well have to believe in that.
Yes, and so, I think very well put through. I think that is something. Nobody questioned the ability. It's about only thing is the way you make it happen. I think, believe me, I always feel women are the better planner and better executors than men. but yes, I think it's a great journey. Your last on this show, for today's talk show, what is your message to the budding entrepreneurs who want to be in sports tech industry, or people who are looking for career in sports analytics as an industry?
My opinion or my advice to them is, basically, I personally feel that sport itself is an industry which is booming at the moment. It's just not because people are now playing a lot of sport, but technically, you see that because in India and outside as well, sport is now has taken a shape as a professional career, which was not there earlier. So in pursuit of becoming a professional player or a good player, there are other avenues also which opens up. It's just not becoming a professional player. That experience and that exposure when you actually start playing from a younger age brings you to a level wherein you can push yourself into multiple other areas as well, like sports management or maybe sports physiotherapy, biomechanics, and then psychology or sports management. So there are many other aspects which are coming up now, and I personally feel that with the kind of this industry, the way it is booming, and the kind of awareness which is happening by the Indian government as well, in India and outside as well, there's more and more people or more and more among students or small kids will come out and play, because in this digital era where many of the kids and parents I think are very if for them it's a difficult time to keep away their kids from mobiles or iPads. They are more happy to put their kids into sports. And when you are putting their energy and channelizing in it in a right direction, you'll have a bright youth going forward.
Right. So excellent. And somebody who is looking for their making their career in sports analytics, anything about the mindset that you want to talk about? That how you they should be perceiving this industry?
Yeah. So I think there are two things which I want to say. So I know that shifting. Or doing a career in sports analytics will have its own demands. I would definitely would like to call out that. I would say that if someone is interested in sports analytics and planning to actually move their career into it, it would be good if they have some technology background or some sort of analytics, or having a knowledge of some languages like Python or AI, or maybe software development experience as well will be good. And or they have some experience in statistics or mathematics. So I personally feel that will add an advantage to them. That's one thing. And secondly, I personally feel that even if you're not having that experience, if you're passionate about it, if you're willing to work on it, like I was, although I was not having that background of sport, I could do it because of the passion. So you can definitely do it. And another thing which I want to add here is that I think this industry itself is booming. I think after 4 or 5 years, this industry is expected to reach $1 million business. So that's what is one of the study I was going through. It is going to reach $1 billion of business. So it's going to be a good career, and you can work with many great athletes, many federations, and you can be in that sporting culture. It's just that you have that understanding and passion towards sport. So that is very important for anything which you would like to do in your career.
I think very well put through. I think it gives the right perspective about what amateur should be looking at, how professionals should be looking at, from their helping stupa, helping them with the whole mindset. To we spoke about entrepreneurship, we spoke about what the aspirants of the industry should be looking at. I think, Megha, it was wonderful covering all the aspects of what you want to talk about today. And whenever we speak next, I'm looking forward to having more demo probably that we can look at about how the whole stupa works and something that do. But yes, I think we'll keep that for the in-person thing and not the virtual thing. So. With that, thanks a lot. Thank you for your time, and really appreciate having you on this, and look forward to talking to you soon and meet you soon.
Thank you so much, sir. And I wish you all the best with this new initiative. I'm quite excited about it. So I hope this goes very well.
Yes, I hope so. And we are just doing it for educational purpose, aspirational purpose, inspirational purpose, and giving a direction to the industry that we love the most. I also quit the whole IT and came into sports for my passion for sports. So if we people can do it, I think there's a phenomenal opportunity for this industry. And that's what just want to using this platform just to make sure that it reaches to maximum people, and they inspire about sport, they inspire about people that they listen to. We've been talking about icons, idols, heroes, sheroes. I think trying to give a platform and share the knowledge.
Yeah, I think it's really nice. And that's what I mentioned in the beginning as well, that I personally feel that it can be a good platform for the people who are looking their career in sport. It's just not for that, even for us as well, who are into sport right now. We are working in the sports arena, and it is good for us as well to know what others are doing, what's their point of view, and have a good network around it. So it's a very, very nice initiative.
Thank you. I really appreciate the kind words, and hope it goes in the direction that we are thinking about, and we'll grow it together. We are all in it together.
Yes, it will definitely.
Yes. Thank you, Megha. Thank you. So much, sir. Thank you. Take care. Stay safe.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Please do like, share, and subscribe. Please do subscribe to our channel and help us spread the word about Sportsy, where we are going to talk about sports more and more. Thank you.